Hey, welcome or welcome back to my channel. I'm Don, and today I'm going to be reading you my personal statement that got me admitted to my master's social work program. The reason why I wanted to do this video is because I wanted it to serve as a form of guidance for prospective MSW students, as well as motivation for current MSW students, and as a trip down memory lane for MSW graduates who are working in the field. The essay is broken up into three parts, the first being my interest in social work, the second being my experiences related to social work, and the third being support. When I was in the sixth grade, I was privileged in visiting the University of Chicago. It was then that I knew I was going to college. When it came time to choose a major, I knew I wanted to major in something that would have a positive impact on vulnerable populations. However, my only definition of helping others was through curing illnesses, which led me to pursue a career in medicine. Throughout my pre-medical extracurricular leadership positions, I found myself taking on the role of communicating information to the public verbally and non-verbally through flyers, social media, and videography. I knew I did not want to become a physician after three medical internships at the University of Illinois, University of Chicago, and Louisiana State University. After attending a workshop that labeled my extracurricular experience as public relations, I discovered that my institution offers a BA in it, which led me to change and complete my degree to Communication Studies, Public Relations, with a minor in psychology. During my studies, I took courses where I learned about various disparities that affected marginalized groups. This fueled my passion to help people even more. As my undergraduate studies ended, my wife Kiana Lampkins has undergone her own application process for the Master of Social Work program at the University of Illinois at Urbana-Champaign campus. Having visited Illinois numerous times with my wife, I've learned a wealth of information about the program. This prompted me to have countless conversations with former employee Darnell Fisher in January 2014 and Christy Avgar twice at Eastern Illinois University's Graduate School Fair and at Illinois November Open House along with Dr. Susan Cole. It was at the open house that I knew in detail about the five concentrations and the differences between them. It was at the open house that I conversed with current faculty and students about their experience. And it was at the open house that confirmed my interest in social work and specifically this institution. I am choosing to pursue a career in social work because of its versatility and its ability to help others. Becoming a social worker will allow me to support individuals in need and to bring true change in the lives of those who need it most. Using individuals' strengths and helping them better help themselves is what interests me in social work. Specifically, my experience in providing guidance has fueled my desire to help others. As a tutor for young adults who were conditionally admitted to Eastern Illinois University, I was presented with many students who dealt with identical anxieties that I overcame. It is impossible to focus and function properly when one does not know how to cope with unfortunate circumstances. Whether it was providing stress relief activities or suggestions in adjusting to change, I provided ways for students to cope with their own unfortunate circumstances. When I envision my career goals, it includes becoming a clinical mental health social worker. I also see myself being a researcher in the field to contribute to the growth of mental health social work, specifically conducting research in substance abuse among adolescents and young adults on college campuses definitely will be a focal point, especially after obtaining a PhD in social work in the latter part of my career. University of Illinois School of Social Work will teach me to practice in any setting, in any population. I know I will be trained to function independently as well as interdependently. The broadness in the degree requirements will educate me in macro and micro social work practice. During my visit, throughout my interactions with multiple professors of the Master's Social Work program, it became clear how much they care about their students. The students talk about how the classrooms are interactive and that the student-teacher ratio is very good. The students also express gratitude that all of their classes are in one building because it builds a sense of community. Since I volunteer often, I look forward to joining the Graduate Social Work Association to continue to make a positive impact in communities facing many disparities. Participating in two research projects my senior year, I would love an opportunity to discover new solutions with world-class professors. The field placement will elevate my experience in allowing me to have a two-semester internship in my identified interest, so I am well prepared to enter the field of social work upon graduation. These are all the things that I not only expect, but would love to experience. Identifying as a Christian, the Holy Bible serves as a moral compass as to how I ought to live my life on earth. Being active in my faith, I serve as an executive board member as the public relations chair for a campus ministry. I am also a student of the minister ordination program. Functioning in these leadership roles, I've developed an important value: service. Identifying myself as a servant leader, I believe in sharing power, putting the needs of others first, and helping people develop and perform as highly as possible. Working with the vulnerable population, I must put the needs of others first and help them to develop and perform as highly as possible. Valuing service will allow me to put the person first and help them to develop and perform as highly as possible. As an African-American male alumni from a predominantly white institution, I've encountered numerous people that differ. However, this has not been my most challenging encounter with diversity. My most challenging is providing counsel with individuals that differ in religiosity. One time, my wife and I were thrifting at Goodwill. We ran into a classmate who was saying how she had nothing to do one upcoming weekend. This prompted us to speak about our campus ministry we're involved in. I was not expecting our classmate to stop me in the middle of my sentence to say, "I don't believe in God." Internally, I was startled because I never had anyone directly say that to me before. I genuinely asked her to tell us more about living a life where she doesn't believe in anything. She began to describe how she feels connected to the universe. I remember her saying she loves to walk barefoot to feel the texture on the ground. She loves how sharp the grass feels and how hot the concrete sidewalks are. She says that she feels connected to the universe. After this conversation, I wanted to learn more about what she said, so I did some research. It turns out that if she had to label her connection to the universe, it would be a pantheist. I don't know if I'm saying that right. One who believes the universe is God. What I learned from this experience is that everyone is not the same. Every encounter with someone is an opportunity to learn more about an individual and to provide help from a perspective that they can use and that they will be comfortable with. It also allows us to grow as a person by being culturally aware and accepting. In my church, there are many students who face anxiety from cognitive dissonances between their desires and their religious practices. For instance, as a cultivating minister in the minister ordination program, we are assigned individuals and couples to counsel. Once I met with a young man who identified himself as agnostic. He wanted to learn more about Christianity, but was apprehensive because his peers believe in God while he questioned his faith. Being well known in the church, he grew concerned that people would find out and judge him. Sensing this concern, I immediately assured him that confidentiality was something he did not have to worry about. I've learned that an important aspect of providing services includes confidentiality. As a future practitioner, upholding confidentiality at all times is essential in providing services to people, especially because you may help someone you know one day. I will be an extraordinary social worker for three reasons: service, compassion, and ability. Having the value of social work, I am motivated to ensure stressful situations as a future social worker. I have the heart to work long hours that often require sacrifice of personal time to tend to the needs of others. My compassion draws from my experiences in battling depression and anxiety, which derived from being bullied by my peers during my elementary years, and placing high expectations on myself during all of high school and the first 2 years of college. I believe that if I achieved greatness, it would trump any negative statement said about me from my past, and I would become a person that no one could critique negatively. Learning that this is not the way, I overcame those negative thoughts and emotions through practicing my faith. I have the compassion to be that help in times individuals feel helpless. The thought of providing help to people who need it most gives me strength to keep going, because I know how it feels to need help and not have it available. Having the ability is key. I have the ability to be a social worker because I have a teachable mentality. I am open to learning from anyone knowledgeable and or gifted in an area that I'm not. I appreciate any opportunity to learn. One key aspect of ability is integrity. Although I've provided counsel, I never posed as a professional in providing assistance and aiding individuals in utilizing available sources to their advantage. I've always been able to refer the proper resources when it was above my ability. I believe through proper training, I would be a great social worker to multiple populations, being able to function in any setting. While my wife and I were engaged, we evaluated our assets and debts. Individually, I'd accumulated nearly $30,000 in student loans. Collaboratively, we were close to $60,000 in student loans. After the evaluation, we made a commitment to avoid taking out loans by any means. Going into the next academic year, we were determined to gain grants, scholarships, etc., to avoid taking out more loans. We have set the goal of gaining financial support through obtaining scholarships, fellowships, assistantships, and/or grants to cover the cost of our MSW. Having been a recipient of multiple departmental, external, and university scholarships during my undergraduate education, I am confident that I will obtain financial support for my Master of Social Work education. Before Kiana and I united in marriage, we were best friends. I remember during my time of anxiety, she was the most stable form of support I had. Kiana would visit me at my residence hall, and we would just laugh the day away. When we visited each other, I was able to function. She helped me more than she will ever realize just by being a friend. So I know that as my wife and helpmeet, she will support me as I will support her from start to completion of the program. As married college students, we both are employed students. We work to pay our rent and utilities. Not being eligible for government assistance, we have learned to be responsible and to search a little harder for assistance. Whether it's going to a food pantry for groceries or going to a nonprofit for assistance, we made sure to gain support where needed. I will succeed in graduate school because I have endurance. I will utilize every resource available to me in achieving my dream. I remember I was going into my senior year with cumulative grade point average, and I knew I needed help because I always wanted to go to graduate school, which requires a grade point average. This prompted me to find help. Discussing it with my wife about receiving academic help, she told me about the TRIO program and how it helped her succeed throughout college. I applied and was immediately admitted going into my senior year. Through TRIO, I learned to be academically focused and to strive harder for excellence. I learned how to study, how to effectively read, prioritize, and stay organized. I'm proud to say that through support, I have graduated with a cumulative grade point average. Thanks so much for watching, and until I see you next time, be you, be great.